everyone, this is Krish Ramos, Head of Social Media Publishing for Digital Media, and I am your host for today, and I'm filling in for Jeffrey Hidalgo for another special episode of Pillow Talk. You can always send us your questions as we go along or drop us a line at the comment section down below as we bring out our guest for today. And if you missed out on this episode, don't worry guys, because we will be uploading the full episode on our official website, that's lifestyle.abs-cbn.com, and you can always follow us on our official accounts on Twitter and on Instagram, that's at abs-cbn lifestyle. So guys, are you ready to meet our guest for today? Because we are about to get down and dirty. But as you can see, it's a different location now as compared to our past episodes. There's no bed, there are no pillows or blanket. But I can assure you guys, all of the questions would be as hot and sexy as in the past. Okay, so he moved to Australia when he was just 18 to take polo playing seriously. And if you follow the recently concluded SEA Games, you know that this fellow next to me helped win the Philippines silver in the sport of games. Joining us is polo athlete Gus Aguirre. Thank you guys, thank you for the claps and round of applause. Hi Gus, hi. Welcome to our special episode here in Pillow Talk. So, relax ka lang, chill. But I have a question because I know the fans are dying to know this. Do you know how to speak in Philippines?
Yeah, I do.
Thank God, I'm not gonna die speaking in English for like 30 minutes of this episode. But okay, first question, how did you start falling in love with the sport?
I started falling in love with the sport because I moved to Australia. Mm-hmm. I moved onto a farm there, mm-hmm. where basically if you are not into horses, yeah. and you don't like polo, then mm-hmm. you don't have anything to do there. So I started getting into it, I started riding a lot, and yeah. Here I am.
Thank who motivated you? Who inspired you?
Mainly my dad. My dad, he has always pushed me into the sport for years, for decades. And for a while I didn't like it, but now I do, and I think he's really happy, really pleased about the fact that I like it now.
Aside from your dad, what kept you pushing forward?
The desire to be competitive. I'm a very competitive person.
Oh.
If we're playing cards or board games, I'm still extremely competitive. I'm competitive about everything. So, yeah, this is a way for me to express myself and remain competitive on a good, serious level. So.
Mm-hmm. What other sport do you like?
I like soccer. I like martial arts, jiu-jitsu mm-hmm. mainly. Yeah, those are two other sports that I have played in the past.
How was life after SEA Games? What did you do? How did you celebrate?
I actually won silver, not gold. Mm. So
but it's
I
still a win.
Yeah, right. Yeah. But I think not the end result that everyone wants. Of course, when you compete, everyone wants gold.
Yeah.
So it was to get silver instead of gold was kind of extra motivation to keep pushing. So we have our season here in Manila in January, so currently ongoing. So after the SEA Games ended on the 1st of or 2nd of December, I just kept at it, trying to get ready for the season
here. For the next competition,
yeah.
right? Yeah. You're currently training now.
Yeah, yeah.
What kind of training do you usually do?
Mainly a lot of riding. Mm. Yeah, I'm on a horse almost every day. Sometimes the horses need to rest as well, so then they get a day off, but if the horses are up for it and I am, then I'm riding a lot and working on my swing, on everything, on all the swings, all the different types of things that you can work on, such as control, hitting big, backhands, all that, yeah.
You've mentioned earlier that when you won silver, it actually motivated you to do better and to push for more.
Yeah.
What's the best life quote you've heard or piece of advice that was given to you in the past? You still can remember up to now, and you can share to our viewers who are probably going the same thing as you are.
Yeah. Well, so I think it's probably this one, that success is just failing over and over and over again and not quitting. So when you fail at something that you're trying to be good at, don't stop, keep going, because it's pushing past that feeling of wanting to quit and all of those negative things that will eventually get you better. Yeah.
Well, thank you for sharing that. I would probably remember that and watch this episode again after.
Yeah.
And try to remember that. Okay, next question. What's the one thing people don't know about you?
I'm
sure a lot of your fans are curious to know.
Yeah. That's the one thing. It's a tough one. I spend days on end on a farm, not living a glamorous lifestyle that polo. Because I play polo, a lot of people think it's glamorous and that there's champagne and women in high heels and hats and amazing dresses and heaps of social events. No, it's not like that, because I'm on the professional side of things, and the way for us to get better is to keep practicing, keep improving. So if you're spending time in the city every day, you're not going to improve. You need to be at a place where you can isolate yourself and keep riding horses, where there are facilities to ride horses, such as polo fields and arenas, things, all the things you need to get better. And for me, my training ground is on a farm in Australia, about 4 hours away from the city. So that's where I spend
most of the time. You're there.
Yeah, I'm there. I'm dirty. I'm picking up horse poo. I'm cleaning boxes and cleaning horses. And yeah, so that's where I spend majority of
the next
my time.
Question. We have questions from the fans. This was chosen by the fans and from the fans. What's your go-to drink at a bar? I'm not sure if I should ask this, because you said you try to stay away as much as possible from bars or parties.
Yeah, but I think we all have our preference. Yeah. I like Johnny Walker Black on the rocks. Yeah, simple, and I don't like to mix, so if I start with that, then I go with that the whole night.
Ladies.
With a touch of water.
Remember that. What qualities would you look for in a partner?
In a partner? Just someone with qualities.
Physical. Let's start with the physical.
Somebody good looking. Someone I'm attracted to. I think that type of person can come in all different shapes and sizes.
So you don't have a specific type. You don't like, I just like tall women or petite women or brunette or blonde.
I don't mind. I just would rather she not be taller than me, if possible.
Okay, if you weren't a polo player, what would you be?
What would I be? I think I'd probably be doing business. I do a bit of business here with my family in the Philippines.
What sort of business?
Mainly real estate development. Property management, so leasing, renting out commercial spaces, or building residential housing as well. That's interesting to me.
The next question is so funny. How do you stay so, there's a lot of O in that sentence, buff, so buff. How do you stay so buff?
By riding a lot. I'm always active, so I don't have, so even if I eat a lot, I can lose the weight easily because I'm always doing something, always riding or running. Or
you don't have a specific workout?
No, I actually don't use the gym anymore. I used to work out a lot, but it's not so good for flexibility, and you need to be flexible for polo, so I try not to lift too many weights.
How did you discover that it wasn't like the workout you were trying or doing wasn't good for flexibility?
I just realized from lifting that you become so tight, and it's almost, you don't need to be overly strong in polo to play. I think the most important factor in terms of strength is having the horse strong. So you actually should, as a rider, should be lighter, so the horse has less weight to carry and more flexible, so you can lean out and hit certain shots that you need flexibility in order to hit.
Right. We also have male viewers right now, and they are dying to know your secret. What's your dating tips? Can you give them or share a few dating tips?
Just be real and be nice and be respectful, because, I think being real is important, because you don't want someone to get to know you when you're dating, and then, a couple months down the track, you're actually not who you advertise yourself to be. So you end up having problems because yeah, it's
showing your real self.
Exactly.
Right.
Yeah. And if just be comfortable, and if you feel for any reason that you're not comfortable with the person that you're with, then maybe it's not the right fit. Yeah.
Okay, let's make this session a more hotter part, because all the girls are looking forward to this. Okay, we have a this or that segment.
Yeah.
Okay, you just have to choose between the two options and I'm gonna tell you.
Okay.
Okay, but in a fast, very fast.
Okay.
Wait, okay. This or that, wine or beer?
Beer.
This or that, hugs or kisses?
Hugs.
This or that, text or video?
Text.
This or that, form or function?
Function.
Giver or receiver?
Giver.
Your place or theirs?
My place.
Toys, yay or nay?
Why not? Spice it up.
Rough or gentle?
Gentle.
This or that, screamer or moaner?
Moaner.
Ribbed or studded?
Ribbed.
Spit or swallow?
My preference? Or?
Yeah, your preference.
Of course. Probably swallow.
Journey or destination?
Journey.
Okay, I would just like to make it clear that I didn't write the script for this. For all of you who are watching this right now, I didn't write that. Okay, we have another game for you. It's called a Would You Rather Challenge. So again, you have to choose.
Yep.
Okay, would you rather kiss in public for 2 minutes? This is with a stranger. Or be together naked in private but no kissing?
I would rather be together in private with no kissing.
With no kissing.
Naked with no kissing, yeah.
Kissing. Okay, next. Would you rather eat something spicy for a minute or eat sweets nonstop for a day?
Eat something spicy for a minute.
Oh, so you don't like anything sweet?
I do like
You're
sweet food, but it's probably healthier, and I'm trying to look after myself.
Always.
So yeah, I'll go with the spicy
okay.
thing for a minute.
Would you rather kiss someone you don't know or kiss your best friend's girlfriend?
I would rather kiss someone I don't know.
Would you rather dirty dance with a drunk girl or do body shots with your ex?
I would rather do body shots with my ex because I hate dancing.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, we might ask you to dance later.
No, don't do that.
Okay, next. Would you rather fart inside an elevator or pee while someone's watching?
I'd rather pee while someone's watching.
Really?
Yeah.
I think it's easier to deny that you farted inside an elevator, though. Okay, would you rather have a hickey or give a hickey?
I'd rather give a hickey.
Now you know, ladies. Now you know. Would you rather take a bubble bath or a steamy shower with someone?
I'd rather take a bubble bath.
Next, would you rather wear someone else's underwear or use someone else's toothbrush?
I'd rather wear someone else's underwear.
Okay, last two. Would you rather be stranded in an island alone or with the person you hate the most?
I would rather be stranded in an island alone.
Would you rather cheat and be caught or be cheated on and never be told?
I'd probably rather cheat and be caught.
Oh, okay. Last round of questions from the ladies, from our women viewers out there. Worst date ever?
Worst date ever. What about it? Go in detail?
Yeah,
I've been on a date where I pretty much know immediately that it's not gonna work, but you still have to. You can't just say hi, I'm here, and we don't match, so bye. So you've got to sit through the date.
Okay.
And try to find some things to talk about when you know it's not already not gonna work out. Yeah, so probably one like that.
So you just suffered in silence.
Yeah,
while
try to be polite. I assume, yeah.
Okay, you stalk girls online?
No.
No. To all of you guys who are sending us your Instagram account, sorry, it doesn't stalk online. What attracts you? What keeps your attention?
In a girl? Or?
Yeah, in a girl.
Someone charismatic with and very confident in themselves. I think that like someone confident will radiate that look about themselves, that they're confident in themselves and that in themselves, and that yeah, they're like, hey, I'm here, and if you're brave enough, talk to me. If not, then I don't have time for you. I find that attractive.
Confidence, ladies. Now you know, confidence. So if you see him somewhere here, where do you usually hang out aside from, like, here in the Philippines, here in Manila?
I live in the south near Alabang, so I'm often in the Alabang area. Mm-hmm. In Molito, I come here to Manila Polo Club a lot because mm-hmm. I practice here twice a week and I play here once a week. So yeah, mainly Alabang and yeah, sometimes Makati for it to have a nice dinner or a few drinks.
So if you see Gus anywhere in those areas, you just approach him because confidence is key.
Or ignore me and or I'll approach you.
Or ignore him and then he'll approach you. You're welcome, ladies, because I asked all of the questions that you wanted me to ask to Gus. And that is it. Thank you so much for being with us. Do you want to promote anything? Your fans, or message to your fans who've been watching your career, stalking you
Yeah, I'll just say thank you for the support. Yeah, it gives me confidence to know that there are a few people behind me rooting me and wanting me to excel. So thank you for that, and all the best to everyone.
Thank you guys for being with us here and Hello Talk, and for being so smart about all of our questions and for answering all of our sexy questions in our challenges. And again, thank you guys for being with us here on Hello Talk and for joining our sexy conversations. Again, if you missed this episode, don't worry, because we will be uploading the full episode on our official website, that's lifestyle.abs-cbn.com. And again, follow us on our official Twitter and Instagram accounts, that's at abs-cbn lifestyle. Thank you guys, and also thank you to everyone who made today's episode possible. Thank you to WeWork Philippines for having us, Aldrin Ramos for styling, and Team MVP for our grooming. And of course, also Katrina Pascual. See you in the next episode, guys. And remember, this is all just Pillow Talk.